Ho!
Hey, only, yeah. Yeah. Oh, man.
Wow.
Good job.
Some days, pretty tight.
Some days, it's really loose.
That's what she said.
Exactly.
That's how the story goes.
How the story goes.
Grimpen Gaming does it.
Has there ever been a movie or a TV show called That's What She Said?
No, I don't think so. It should be.
There should be. It's like such a ubiquitous term.
Yeah. Let's see.
I don't want to watch it, but people would watch
That's what she said game.
Hmm. Is it like a board game or like...
Adult party game.
Ugh.
It does say on the Wikipedia, it's like the North American equivalent of the British expression. Remember, we've talked about this.
What's the British expression?
Said the actor to the bishop.
Oh, right. I don't consider it, like, they mean the same thing, but I don't consider it to be a derivative of the other. That's weird.
I don't know. It doesn't say derivatives, it's equivalent.
Oh, okay.
But,
as in just, it's a dumb joke you can say at the end of every sentence?
Yeah, it's like, you just make a euphemism out of whatever the last thing that was said.
Right.
2012 comedy film.
Oh, interesting.
Starring Anne Heche and Aaliyah Shawkat.
Oh, I know who that is.
You don't know who Anne Heche is?
I do, but I don't give a shit about Anne Heche.
Yeah. I didn't even read the first name was starring Marcia Debony.
I don't know who that is.
Kovacs 12 is here. He says, did it win an Oscar? That's what she said.
It didn't win an Oscar. It's not worth watching. That's disappointing.
Probably didn't.
But if it, so that we can't make a That's What She Said movie anymore, it's been taken.
Oh, yeah.
But we could make Said the Actor to the Bishop.
Oh, wait, maybe not. And actually, the Wikipedia said the actress, but that's not as good.
The actress to the Bishop?
Yeah. That's apparently the correct phrase.
Interesting.
But I've always heard actor because that's more fun.
We live in a sexist society. I can't imagine a female actor.
Well, especially if she's being banged by a bishop.
That's true.
I mean, yeah.
So bishop's just been getting it on forever.
I think so.
Oh, man. It's so weird that their job has always included not doing it.
That's the thing. Exactly. That's why. Most. That's why they get it on, because they're told not to.
Right.
It's all repression.
See, but if they were told not to murder, they wouldn't start murdering people.
Yeah, they probably would.
I'm sure they already do as well, but...
And they're not probably, yeah. It's one of those things you usually don't have to say, but...
do you think people get into the church for that sweet sex action?
I don't know. I feel like they get into the church because they're ashamed of their sexual thoughts.
Oh,
and then they repress it, and then they
act on it.
Yeah, exactly. Horribly. And yeah.
Interesting.
And eventually you get the phrase, said the actress to the bishop.
That's the thing. Our movie would actually be more of like a hard-hitting documentary.
Yeah.
Yeah. Not a fun watch.
Kovacs is stoked that we're playing Star Tropics today, but he has to head out in a few minutes, so he'll have to watch the replay. Oh
man. The archive, you won't get our amazing live commentary.
Yeah, you won't be able to join in and say, I loved this part.
Exactly. And if something huge happens in the world while we're playing.
Bananas in my ears. Oh, yeah, and we'll all react. You won't get the news at the same time. Yeah. You just won't be in the zeitgeist.
Exactly. Like when they rediscover dinosaurs while we're playing Star Tropics.
And they'll say, where were you when they rediscovered dinosaurs?
I was at a meeting.
Watching Star Tropics, yeah.
Not nearly as good.
Lame. Well, thanks for voting, though. He voted for Star Tropics.
Oh, good. If he hadn't, it would have lost.
I remember playing Star Tropics with Kovacs. I think I actually brought my cartridge. I don't have it here, though.
Wow.
It's over there. I could go get it, but
It's over there with Kovacs.
They have to get up. Yeah, Kovacs is right there in a meeting. Yeah. The meeting's happening just over there.
The meeting is with you.
No, I'm not part of the meeting. It's just in my apartment.
Okay.
I rent my apartment out for meetings.
It's just a public office space.
Yeah.
Okay. Whatever you got to do in this climate. Wowee. Yeah, tomorrow is my one opportunity at getting a PS5 before the end of the year. So by our next show, we'll know if I'm getting one or not.
Wow. Yeah. That's exciting.
It's crazy how rarely they restock this new thing. You'd think they would have, like, I guess we do live in a pandemic, so what do I really expect?
Kovacs says, Star Tropics is the only RPG I've ever liked. Good memories. Hate to break it to you, but it doesn't really count.
I mean, yeah, that's true. You can really, if you want, you can go any game where you play as a character. As a role.
Yeah. It's barely, yeah, it's not. Yeah,
it Star Tropics not 2 RPG. Has more role-playing game elements? Stuff to it. Yeah, you can like level up your characters and improve your attack and stuff.
And that's still barely, and I barely count it as an RPG.
Right.
Are we going to play Cyberpunk? Probably not, but
yeah,
I don't know. I feel like you might still get sucked into it.
I don't know. And this, it's going to be the easiest one to not get sucked into of all of them so far, though, just because of all the awfulness about the company you read.
Oh, yeah?
Like, it's easy. Oh, yeah, they are bad. But it sounds like Poland in general is a bad place. But it's, yeah, they're not too hard to not support. But it just doesn't look good to me.
Yeah, I'm not that into it either. But I still kind of want to play it.
Yeah. Like, the thing that happened, Witcher came out, I wasn't interested. It got the greatest reviews ever. People said it's the greatest game ever. I was like, oh, crap, this is going to be good. I paid $80 for it, and I played, like, an hour of it.
Yeah,
and I put another $20 in it. I bought the DLC for it and didn't care. It's their games
so
are
you've
boring.
Been kind of burned on their games before.
It's true. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, so I don't know what would convince you then. You'd have to really.
I'd have to see some footage of gameplay that
yeah,
actually.
Maybe
looks
read
fun.
Some reviews where like some kind of something that hasn't been revealed yet makes you go, oh, okay, I could.
Yeah. Exactly. But like of the Cyberpunk games that are out this year, I think I'm more interested in what's it called? Ghostwire or Ghost Runner? The
I don't know.
The weird like cyberpunk ninja game. It's out already.
That sounds fun.
It looks awesome.
Kovac Stoz says they released a preview of the photo mode today and it was meh.
Yeah.
We'll see. Maybe it'd be crazy if it didn't even get the crazy.
It looks
reviews.
Like GTA with neon lights all over it. Like it doesn't look cyberpunk in any way.
I haven't even seen much really. I think I saw some combat, but like like when you get in a car, does it go into third person?
Oh, I don't know that.
Oh, yeah.
It's one of those like when they put out that first trailer and the girl turned into knives. I was like, holy shit, this is what cyberpunk stuff is. It's like people with crazy body mods doing stuff. But now it looks like you're just people with glowing eyes who shoot a lot. Like,
yeah.
I don't know. But yeah, Ghost Runner is the other game I was thinking of, and that is out now, and it looks like much more fun, more active fun.
Yeah, I'm not sure. Oh, yeah, Kovac Stoll says he totally agrees. He thinks the gameplay is going to be disappointing. Yeah, I certainly haven't seen anything where that makes me go, oh, yeah, I got to play that.
Yeah, and really, the biggest plus for it is how realistic and cool Keanu Reeves seems to look.
I guess, yeah, and that he's in a band. And
yeah. Maybe he's in a band in it?
I think so, yeah. Oh,
is it his real-life band? That
no,
they
I don't
made?
Think so.
Oh, okay. I could listen to some Wolfstar. Yeah, and I guess that's kind of the only other big game for the rest of this year, isn't it?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, definitely on that scale, for sure.
Totally.
I was trying to find out who he plays, more about his character, but it's taking too long. Johnny Silverhand.
There's also been too much marketing for the game. Like, they're putting out those, like, Neon City movies or whatever every week, and I don't care to watch those.
Huh. Like, that's what would, it's something like that that would have to convince me to play it.
Right. You'd have to be invested in it before the game even comes out.
Yeah, and be impressed by the storytelling and by the world.
Right.
And be like, totally, okay, yeah, I want to see more of this.
That's true. And I watched the first couple, and they were boring as shit.
Oh, let's see. There you go.
But I don't, yeah, I don't know.
Joe
is going to
keep playing his badass Ruth from Watch Dogs. Thank you very much.
That's just as cool a cyberpunk kind of world in my mind.
Yeah. And then that I can just see right off the bat, oh, that's the, like, there's unique gameplay to that. I don't necessarily want to play it, but if I wanted to, that I can see what's unique about that. Whereas Cyberpunk, I don't know. I haven't really seen anything where I'm like, oh yeah, I see what this game is.
Yeah. Other than me sort of liking the idea of cyberpunk things.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah.
Yeah.
And like, I'm assuming there's gonna be lots of like customization. And like,
probably
body mod kind of stuff.
Yeah. But then, like, I don't even really care for Blade Runner very much. It's more just a concept that I like, but none of the things that actually happen within Cyberpunk has ever really tweaked me.
Right. Like, there's never been one property that is.
Not that I can. I'm trying to think of anything that's. Yeah. Maybe Mute. Mute was totally.
Oh, I hated Mute.
Mute was fucking terrible.
Moon was good.
Is Moon cyberpunk?
It's the same world.
What?
Yeah.
Like the Sam Rockwell movie?
Yeah.
What does that have to do with Mute?
It's the same. Well, it's the same director, and it's all set in the same. There's like references to Moon in Mute, I believe.
I didn't get that at all.
I think so.
Huh. Moon was.
I mean, Moon.
Well, but...
you know, like Moon was. It's all a very solitary thing, so it didn't like
totally
look at what the rest
about...
of the world.
One guy a whole bunch of times.
Yeah.
Yeah. Spoilers.
Alex is cyberpunk.
Oh, cool.
And he uses the hashtag hardcore, so you know it's true.
Yeah. No, it's I'm less interested in this than I was in Last of Us 2 of the huge games.
Mm. Yeah. Yeah, like I just haven't. Yeah, besides, I guess it is the only draw for me right now is Keanu Reeves. And he has his band's called Samurai.
Oh, okay, that's a fun name for a band.
That's the biggest like in that I have right now of like what this game is.
Yeah. I like the yellow cover art. That's a cool choice. Like it stands out really nice, but
yeah.
We're grasping at straws.
I know, that's the thing, but like I still kind of want to play it. Because I could like it. Like, there are things that I'm like, maybe I could get. Yeah, there's an in here, but there's no obvious.
Totally.
Nothing obvious where I'm like, yeah. That stands out to me.
See. The first Game of the Year awards have started coming out.
When does it come out?
Oh, Cyberpunk's December 17th or 11th.
Wow.
Or 7th.
So
it's
is
soon.
It like, yeah, so like we were, like you say, we got lots of like Game of the Year awards coming starting.
It's
to come
not
out.
Gonna get, it's not gonna get in any of them.
How does this work now? Is it just gonna fall into this weird
Game of the Year's always kind of been world. November through November.
I guess, like, but are there any like are there gonna be any 2019?
Some places.
Like I guess the lists that are coming out now. Like in theory, could include some December
stuff from the end of last year, yeah. But also, depending on where you're reading the list from, it might include stuff from last December or this December, but not both.
Right.
Yeah.
I guess. Yeah. Interesting.
Crazy.
I guess usually nothing huge comes out in December.
Other than Cyberpunk this year, and Smash Brothers 2 years ago or whatever.
Was that December?
Wasn't it? Because didn't it get screwed off by the cutoff in the Gaming Awards or something?
Yeah, but that's still November.
Oh, okay.
For Game Awards.
Ridiculous.
Yeah. Cool. Oh, no, you're right. December 7th, yeah.
Aha. But yeah, the Paste Magazine, they did their 40 best games of the year. Their game of the year is Hades.
Hey, nice.
Yeah, but then their second place game I've never even heard of. So
what's that?
What is If Found?
I don't know. Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's see.
Their list is interesting. It's Hades, If Found, Kentucky Route Zero, Astro's Playroom, Umurangi Generation, The Pathless, Animal Crossing, Tony Hawk, Spelunky, Flight Simulator. Like, that's a crazy year.
It has been a very weird year, yeah. Lots of, weird stuff. That, and, yeah, indie games and big stuff kind of...
Yeah, that list even has a pack-in game in it. Like, that list has indie games, huge games, the last episode of a game that's been coming out over the past 3 years. Like, it's got a lot of bizarre stuff.
Well, If Found looks interesting. It's Annapurna.
Oh, yeah.
And it's like, whoops, shoot.
Annapurna's put out some stuff I'm interested in.
Wow. This is weird. Anyway, I guess I have to do this.
What?
I don't know what I'm doing.
Perfect.
It's a mess. Oh, and just I meant to just go to this, too. Hey, McKinley. If Found is a game about going home, coming out, and erasing everything.
So is it a talking simulator?
It looks like a visual novel, basically. Yeah, it looks cool. Like that.
Oh, yeah.
Some crazy like graphics there.
Oh, that art style reminds me of something. I just can't finger what it is. Oh man,
it's published by Annapurna.
So right. Like a, just the person who drew it has definitely done another game. I just can't think of what it is.
Made by Irish developer Dreamfeel. Let's see what Dreamfeel did. It's Utter. No, I don't know what that.
I don't know.
I clicked on Dreamfield. It was like our games, but it was like a whole bunch of stuff that's not their games.
Not real. Huh. Interesting.
It's like they didn't do Outer Wilds.
It sort of reminds me of. wow, what's the name even of that game? Ox something. My brain is falling out my head.
Oxenfree.
Oxenfree, yeah.
Maybe.
It reminds me of that a little bit. It doesn't look like they've made anything else.
Yeah, I can't find anything else.
Yeah. If Found brings queer 90s nostalgia to the Nintendo Switch.
Ah, it's on the Switch, too.
Yeah.
Wow.
Interesting. Depending on what you actually do in the game.
It kind of reminds me, too. Like, I looked at a list of, like, top streaming artists on Spotify.
Oh, yeah.
The number one I'd never even heard of, named Bad Bunny.
Oh, Bad Bunny's fucking huge.
Yeah, never even heard of him.
She's in the...
Her.
Yeah. She's in the, like, same class of rappers as Cardi B and, like, Megan Thee Stallion. And...
Yeah. See, like, I've heard of them.
Right. She's fine. I don't think I could recognize any of her songs.
But, yeah, I'm just out of touch.
What's up, Larko? McKinley says Doom Eternal is coming to the Switch.
No, cool. Oh, yeah, I heard that, too. I think it's in... In the streaming,
it's another
mode,
streaming though. Game, yeah.
And Lackolith is here. Gives us a fun B. McKinley would have voted Pong, but we seemed to have. I wasn't against it actually. I kind of wanted Pong to win, even in a way.
No.
Just because we've never done it and it's on.
I
it's
can't
in
sit
the,
here and talk to you about Pong for an hour.
It's in the gaming. It's in the gaming history intro. It's the only one left that we haven't done.
That's true.
That's why I want to do it. But I'd rather be playing Star Tropics for sure.
That's the bumper sticker I have on my
phone. Lackolith also wanted to torture us with Pong. You had your chance. I mean, they'll be next year. It'll be on there again until it wins.
Totally.
But, yeah. We convinced McKinley to vote for Star Tropics.
We made an impassioned plea.
We did. I promised I'd stick bananas in my ears, and I did.
Oh man, that's great. Did you wash the bananas first?
Nope.
Oh boy.
You're unclean gonna have the, bananas.
You're gonna have the banana illness now.
Yeah, that's what I wanted. Gonna be like that's how, I'm pretty sure that's how Last of Us started.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So there's gonna be some Star Tropics later.
Sweet. What's the other game you're playing?
What were we just talking about? Oh,
we were talking about If Found.
Oh yeah, and just games of the year.
Games of the year. I'm excited for Game of the Year awards because there's been so much smaller stuff that's come out this year. And I think there's going to be a lot of weird ones that win in place.
It was a weird year for big stuff. Like there wasn't a lot. It was kind of surprising.
There's like five of them. Yeah.
Yeah. So indie stuff had a chance to shine.
Yeah, exactly. Apple named Genshin Impact as the iPhone game of the year. I don't know what. I've heard of that
game. A lot of people like that game, yeah.
But it's a gacha game, isn't it?
Yeah, but it's also like Breath of the Wild. Like it was the game that originally got made news for like looking like it's a direct steals assets from Breath of the Wild.
Right, but it doesn't quite.
But no, I guess not. But it's very very similar. But people like it.
I don't know what it'll take for me to play like a full game on my phone again at this point. Like a game that's not just Sudoku or Trivia or something.
Yeah.
It's such a weird, like, especially with the Switch. The Switch just does everything that a phone game could do, but 100 times better.
And in a pandemic.
Maybe not better, just more comfortably.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's true.
Totally is.
When did they stop making Kingdom Rush games?
Oh, man. They must
those.
Have.
I loved those games.
Yeah.
I could have just used one of those every couple of years.
They only ever do two. I remember Kingdom Rush and Kingdom Rush Frontier.
I think there was a couple more, but maybe just one or two more. I think there was one called Origins.
Hmm. Oh, also Kingdom Rush Vengeance.
Oh, I don't think I played Vengeance. Maybe I missed one.
It's the most expensive one.
What's gotcha? What's Kingdom Rush?
Gacha games are the games where it's gambling, where you buy like a pack of heroes and hope you get an epic hero or something, but who knows what you're going to get in your pack. And then you play as whatever characters you get and put money in to hopefully get more and better heroes.
Yeah, they're like ball machines.
Those are called, gachapon machines in Japan.
Yeah. And Kingdom Rush is a phone. It is just a tower defense game, basically.
Yeah, it was around the beginning of the tower defense craze.
Just a really popular tower defense game.
It was iPhone tower defense game for a while.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was really good and, like, yeah, really hard. And
totally. All tower defense games are too hard.
Yeah, true. Maybe I just put enough time into this one that I actually got over the curve.
Right.
I mean, this is like loot crates? Yeah, kind of.
Yeah,
more or less. They pretty
but you go. Have to get the you like you get your one free loot crate when you start the game, and everything else you get you have to pay for in the game.
But it's random still.
But it's random, yeah.
Yeah.
But also not necessary. You could play through the game with your shitty first hero and be fine, probably.
Yeah, yeah. I don't know too much about it, but it's super popular.
It is. I also hate the art style of it, like of the characters at least. Looks real
very,
damn bad.
Very anime.
Very anime.
It's all right. It looks all right. Not for me.
Nope.
McKinney remembers, now that he thinks about it, he remembers hearing about a gacha Metal Gear.
Oh, well, they had gachapon machines that were Metal Gear themed in Japan. I don't know about a game.
Yeah, I don't think they had a game. Yeah.
They had the Metal Gear Pachinko game. That might be what you're thinking of. I would have loved it. It was Metal Gear Solid 3, actually.
Right.
That would be pretty sweet.
That was kind of like emblematic of Konami.
Konami not knowing what the hell's going on.
Yeah, just not, yeah. not handling their franchise as well.
Exactly. They own like a series of gyms, and that's what keeps them in business in Japan. I wish they would just theme their gyms after their licenses.
Totally.
Like, I'm going to go to the Gym Sylvania today.
Everything's just be themed.
Yeah, you just whip candlesticks for an hour and you get ripped.
Or, yeah, go to the Metal Gear Solid one and like crawl through vents. And...
That'd be so good. Except you'd have to sit through an hour and a half of someone telling you like... why you're working out.
Yeah, totally. But you'd be working out while they did it.
Yeah, it'd be, that's true.
Yeah, you'd have to do... Oh, maybe not, actually. I guess sometimes you just have to crouch and listen to them for
yeah.
a long time sometimes.
Hope nobody sees you.
And you learn CQC.
I'd be great. It would be handy to know CQC.
Totally. Yeah. Some close quarters combat.
Yeah.
Get right in people's faces and punch them.
Oh, that's man.
Super
useful.
This
is a crazy news story. You know the giant like inner telescopes that they're at the end of GoldenEye, the end of the movie where they're running around? It collapsed.
Collapsed, I know.
That's crazy.
I know. And it was, yeah, featured in the movie GoldenEye and in the game. They announced like a couple weeks ago that they were like going to retire it.
Oh, okay.
I guess because it was going down, but then it...
Right.
And it just
went down. Oh, man. That's too bad. Now I can never visit those telescopes.
It does look like there's some new photos, though, I just saw here, yeah.
Yeah, there's a cool one with a big hole in it.
It's all like... there's all these like trees in it.
See, like, that's almost as sad to me as actors dying.
It is a pretty badass thing.
Yeah.
It's like so. It's just in the middle of nowhere, too.
Totally. Oh, it's such a cool thing. And like, what was it there for other than to listen for aliens?
I think that was what it was there for.
Yeah. So good.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah, it really fell apart.
It's too bad. People should have been using it still. People should have been keeping it up and making it beautiful.
I think, well, I don't know. I don't know if people were, I think people were using it. Maybe they weren't. But
oh, it wears down.
Yeah, I don't think they were upkeep. Like, it would cost too much money to like rebuild it, I think.
That's true. And really, yeah, just getting all that stuff shipped out into the middle of a jungle somewhere.
Yeah, that's true. Just getting in there alone.
If I was like Sean Bean, though, I would for sure buy that and just build a house.
I don't think Sean Bean has the money for that. Yeah, what do you think Sean Bean has?
I don't know. He's got to be a millionaire.
What do you think?
How much do we think a piece of land with a collapsed satellite dish on it costs? Can't be that much.
Million. Oh, yeah. That's hundreds of millions of dollars.
Hundreds of millions of dollars?
Yeah,
I don't know.
Maybe I don't know what to maybe not to buy it since it's all falling apart.
Exactly,
but
it's all it's
actually
in disrepair.
Fix it.
No, just to own it. Well, maybe him and Pierce Brosnan can pool their money.
I don't think they have to if it's falling apart.
Well, like, it's cheap. Like, he can just live in a cool house. Sean Bean can live in a cool house underneath.
I think he probably can though. Like, I don't think anything's going to be stopping you from doing that.
Well, he should do that.
Because they're going to leave it there, I think.
Someone should call Sean up and let him know my idea.
Like, this is James Bond. Yep, totally from GoldenEye.
Yeah. Yeah. Man, GoldenEye is such a great movie. For a movie that's really not actually very good, it sure left an impression on me.
Again, he says it played a role in a Bond movie, so essentially it's a dead actor.
Exactly.
It's true. It showed emotion and had a whole arc.
Yeah. It killed a guy.
Yeah. So we saw its first kill.
But like, imagine
emotional.
If you could buy that up and make like a paintballing course up there, and it would just be the cradle level from GoldenEye.
That would be genius.
Except people would fall off and die.
Well, yeah, you'd have to have like one of those safety systems where you're like in a harness. It's like on a chain. Uh-oh, I just lost Grimpen. Well, I'll just read some comments here. The pachinko thing where you get to drop a ball and it bounces off pegs before landing in a slot. No, it's, I don't even know what pachinko is really. It's just Japanese slot machine, I think, is all that means. I don't know what's happening. Poor network connection. Poor network connection. He's so sad. Like I said, also, it's an odd thing. I guess the modern satellite dishes are much smaller and better. Yeah, probably, eh? That's probably another reason why they're not rebuilding it. I'm going to try phoning him back here. Oh, he's phoning me back.
Ah. I don't know what the hell happened.
That poor network connection.
Oh,
that's what it said online.
It just closed the app straight up on me.
Oh, weird.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's weird. I don't know why it doesn't just cut us off.
Like,
I hung up on you eventually.
Okay. It's really weird.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, should we take a quick break and then play some Star Tropics?
We may as well. I forgot what I was talking about.
Let's do that.
Yay! Tropical Star!
This week in gaming history. Whoa, we're back. Star Tropics. Dong 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 dong.
Stars.
Very little song that plays in the intro there.
I wonder if the reason I don't think about it much is that it just sort of bums me out that they didn't just ignore that this game exists. He's such Nintendo. a perfect Smash Brothers character.
Like it says, oh, Star Tropics made first place? It did, yeah, by one vote, which was McKinley was the deciding vote.
Yeah.
We convinced him to play Star Tropics because I told him I'd put bananas in my ears.
Perfect. So if you are angry about it, take it up with McKinley.
I did.
Lacko says it's also in the Nintendo Online Library.
To truly fulfill my promise. Oh, yeah, that's true. I could have just played it on...
I have not... What a good look.
See? I did it. Actually, if I wanted to do it properly, like Mike Jones, I'd have to peel them halfway.
Is he... Is the scientist in this, is it your grandfather or your uncle?
Your uncle.
Eh, I wish I had an uncle that was a scientist that could start me on cool adventures as a kid.
Totally. I know, right? Yeah. Like, it made everyone's uncles look lame in comparison.
Really does.
Anyway, sorry, one second here. I'm just going to do the title. But this is Star Tropics.
Yes.
One of the more, like, odd and obscure games that's won gaming history. In a long time. Usually it's like one of the more well-known games. But this is kind of just an oddball of gaming history. I guess it's just... It's fairly relevant because it's one of Nintendo's biggest oddballs.
Yeah.
That they've kind of forgotten about, as you said earlier.
It's like... It's in the same category as Metroid and Zelda on the NES in my mind.
Totally. Like, gameplay-wise, and story-wise and stuff, totally. It was right up there with those games. And then they never made another one. I mean, they made Star Tropics 2 on the NES as well, but, I mean...
Zoda's Revenge is, like, 5 times better. It's so good. Like, right. If they could have kept getting better at the rate they were...
But they never even made, like, a Super Nintendo Star Tropics. Let alone, like, when they went to 3D, they would have to reimagine it. But, they just never really looked at this franchise after this game and the next one. It was directed by Genyo Takeda, who we've talked about before when we played Punch-Out. He's the creator of Punch-Out.
Wow.
So it was, like, this was his other series. And I don't know why... I guess we can kind of blame him. Let's start writing him emails and stuff.
He's got to be paying attention, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because, like, I'm pretty sure, like, let's see, does he still, you know, I think he, I don't know if he still does. Let me see.
He designed
Nintendo's first arcade game ever called EVR Race in 1975.
What's his last name? Genya?
Takeda. Takeda.
He's old. I don't know if he'd get my emails.
Like in 2015, he was promoted to co-representative director and given the title of Technology Fellow.
Oh, that's a great title.
So maybe he's still just Technology Fellow.
Hello, Tech Fellow. That's how I'll start my email.
I'm the Technology Fellow. I have this question. Oh, that's really complicated. You're going to have to take that to the Technology Fellow. You'll have to go down this path, up this mountain, through the cave.
Oh, man.
Solve the riddle.
Just sounds like the name of a game.
So anyway, yeah, this game was made by Technology Fellow. Let's play.
Amazing in the credits.
Oh.
I think it's like a minute going, because you have to go and, like, visit the weird... the weird like tribal colony your uncle lived in.
Dort.
Hey, Dort.
Prelude. One day in summer, you land at Sea Island, where Dr. Jones has his laboratory.
What do you think C stands for? Is it? Do you think this is related to Resident Evil? And that's the C vibe?
The island is shaped like a giant C, so I'm pretty sure C just stands for C.
Or it could be the island from Super C. That's also just the letter C.
Maybe.
Yeah.
That's what I think of. I think of the letter C.
Definitely.
Super C. This game was weird even just in how it played. Like, this is like, it had this first section that was kind of like a top-down RPG style where you just talk to guys.
Yeah, here it's just like Zelda 1 a lot, in a lot of ways.
So I can see why, you know, Kovacs, who was here earlier, might think this was an RPG for this reason.
Oh yeah, that's true. But there's not a lot of this.
No. Most of it takes place in the dungeons.
That's true.
I'm an ace pitcher. This guy, well, these guys on this island even know of me. It must be my uncle telling them about my awesome pitching arm.
Oh, that it would have to be your uncle, because I'm like, what 12-year-old gets famous for playing baseball at the age of 12?
Yeah, my uncle is just really talking me up to these islanders.
Yeah.
I'm going to roast a pig for your welcome party. Oh, that's nice. I guess this is the pig she's going to roast.
I love when you go and talk to the chief, it does like a big zoomed in version of the people too. And like, that's way ahead of its time.
Yeah, yeah, you'll see those, yeah. Those graphics look great. Yeah, these look terrible. These graphics.
This just looks like Zelda.
And they're like stunningly bad.
Yeah. Stuff in RPG Maker way nicer looking than this.
Yeah, it looks very early RPG Maker, yeah. Like, just the way that, like, it's so tiled, everything just has a square to them.
Totally. The thing about this game, though, is it's very tile-based.
Like, oh, yeah, definitely.
All of the puzzles involve you, like...
It doesn't have that look, though, in the dungeons as much. Like,
no.
Like,
that's yeah. True.
But this pig just keeps showing me its ass. I think there's something with that pig later. Isn't there like a puzzle or something?
I don't remember that. I think they cook and eat that pig, don't they?
Probably, but...
I don't know.
Thought he like moves or something and there's something there.
It's been a really long time.
Oh, she's Miss Coral 1990. Wow. Speaking of which, this game came out on December 1st, 1990. So she makes sense. She would have been crowned earlier that year.
Yeah.
As Miss Coral. I always loved that effect.
Always. Oh, yeah.
Go into a building. It's like, woo. Like, that was, yeah, that was cool for an NES game. And here we go. Yeah, look at that.
It's so good. Like, he's got such personality.
Yeah, he's so well drawn.
He looks a lot like a Simpsons character.
He's Chief Coracola. Coral Cola.
Oral Cola.
And a good friend of my uncle. Listen, Mike.
Is he Mario?
Yeah, he kind of... He's pretty Mario-esque.
He might be Mario.
If this was voice acted, he would have been voiced by Charles Martinet for sure.
Yeah.
Listen, Mike, I have some bad news. Last night, try to be too upset, but your Uncle Jones has been abducted. We keep this from the islanders so they don't panic. Yeah, I can help. You may think this is just... this yo-yo is just a toy, but it's very powerful. Mike, you're an ace pitcher. Use it!
Use it!
Does an ace pitcher come in handy when you use a yo-yo as a weapon?
I guess because you throw it out really hard.
I guess that is the main function.
Better be good at catching, though, because that thing's going to just come and slam you back right in the wrist. Yeah, as hard as
that was dangerous. Alex says it's the jaundice. What's the jaundice?
Oh, that's why he looks like a Simpson.
Oh.
It's true.
Last night I gazed up at the Southern Cross. Suddenly I saw many shooting stars.
I wish we could just infect an entire town's population with severe jaundice. Just to live in a town that looks like it's all Simpsons.
Yeah, that's pretty evil, mad scientist of you.
Yeah, I guess it is. Maybe not evil. I'd say chaotic.
Yeah, but they're all dying of jaundice, aren't they?
I don't think you die from jaundice. Oh. It just is liver deficiency.
I don't know much about jaundice.
I think if they just don't do a lot of drinking, they should be fine.
I come from Americola.
Oh.
She's just crazy and thinks that every place has to have the word cola in it. I wonder if this place is just sponsored by a Coke company.
Probably. That day, Coca-Cola made an island in the shape of a sea.
It's starting to make sense.
Left like a tribal people here. Figure out what happens if you evolve from scratch, except you have Coke as well.
He's like hypnotizing me. That's a crazy experiment. The houses don't need a roof because it's always sunny on Star Tropic Island, says Lacko.
Oh man,
it's a beautiful
I love that
place. Yeah, I mean this, and now we got the shaman and the sister of the island chief. Like, this is an awesome place to live. Who needs roofs?
Where we're going, we don't need roofs.
Magic of the Southern Cross. She's talking about the Southern Cross a lot. I'm not sure what she means by that. Awesome music. Man, this brings back memories. Oh, so does that pause screen. That's great. That's so great that he just turns into the other.
It's amazing.
Other graphic. Alex is great Alex. Music. Yeah. So good.
You get to be such a cool 90s teen in this game, using a yo-yo and a baseball bat.
Totally. And it was very unique. Like, the fact that now we're in the dungeons and it plays totally differently.
Yeah.
And Mike even has a completely different character sprite.
Totally.
He's taller.
It feels like this inspired a lot of the dungeons in, like, Link to the Past. In a lot of ways.
I can see that, yeah.
Although this is also just the dungeons from Zelda 1, 2.
It's very... It's Zelda, but it isn't. Like, it's...
Yeah.
It's a very unique
This is the
thing
that I want.
I know, I want them... That'd be amazing for them just to make a new 2D Star Tropics.
Or imagine if they took the Breath of the Wild engine and were like, we're bringing Star Tropics back.
The only hope for that could ever have happened is if Sakurai would have ever put him in Smash Bros. But he's not even like an assist trophy or anything.
Not mentioned. His music's not in there. It's...
No, I think he's just like, I think he might be a, well, I don't even know what they are, stickers? Or...
Has to be then. Instead of talking to the technology fellow, we need to make him and Sakurai become really good friends.
Oh yeah, but we need to get technology fellow. Well, he's got a. I don't know. Maybe. Do you think he wants to make a new Star Tropics game?
I don't see how he couldn't.
Well, that's the problem. I think I'm worried we have to convince him in the first place.
Maybe that would be tough then, especially if he's like.
Oh
retired.
No, I'm dead.
A retired guy. I don't know how we're going to get him to come out of retirement to make a new game that not a lot of people care about.
Is he retired?
He looked real old.
He's technology fellow, though.
You think you're just technology fellow for life?
Well, I would assume a technology fellow is like over 80.
Right.
At least. And then they probably served for a while. Got a lot of wisdom to share.
That's true. With their fellow humans.
Like it says, oh, he can't swim. Oh, yeah, that's his weakness.
It's a dangerous life.
I'm not sure how to do this, actually. Maybe there's, like, switches I haven't. Secret switches. Oh, right. Doesn't every room have, like, a switch that opens the door?
I think so, or killing all the enemies.
Oh, maybe, yeah. This was a very hard game.
Huh.
I remember. Maybe not now in retrospect, but as a kid.
Right. Yeah, I don't remember that part, but.
I certainly didn't get very far. It was also pretty cryptic about what you had to do sometimes.
Huh.
The most notorious example being the code that was in the instruction book.
Oh, right. I love it anytime a game does that, though.
And then you had to actually, there's a code in the instruction book that you couldn't see, but you had to use water on it.
Right.
To reveal it.
That's great.
It's pretty amazing, yeah.
But then you basically have to ruin your instruction book to get
there. Yeah. And then it also means that if you lost the instruction book or like bought it without the instruction book, you're just totally screwed. In the days before the internet.
Yeah, now it's very easy to figure out.
Yeah, but like, you know, you borrowed it from a friend or something and didn't know it, you know, didn't know this was a part. And, I, and it wasn't clear, like... I can't remember how clear it was that you needed the, like, it was in the instruction book.
That's why you had to call the Nintendo helpline.
Yeah, probably.
It's true brand synergy. Yeah, these rooms are... I can't imagine what they would look like.
It's a weird kind of jumping puzzle game as well, a lot of it.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
It's like, I can't... Oh, see, like, to go to here, yeah. To get up here, I had to go to the end.
But why do you even have to go up there?
I didn't know. I just thought maybe there'd be secrets.
You found a secret.
Let's see what's in the secret.
So the secret is just to step on every tile.
Oh, a treasure.
Oh, man, what's it going to be? Oh, another secret.
What the?
Oh, what happened? What is it now?
I don't know, matches?
Yeah, 25 matches or torches?
I don't know if that opened the treasure or if it, like, destroyed the treasure and gave me a different treasure.
That I don't know.
And I don't know if this is a secret or if this is just a different way to go.
It's a great question. Doesn't look so hard so far.
I mean, I died once already.
I guess that's true.
Oh!
Oh, those snakes, yeah, they'll just run through you.
Right, yeah, they just see you and then they blast after you. Whew.
Yeah, those suckers.
Maybe that does destroy the chest. But that one, I don't think I could have got any other way.
Now you have 50 torches. Though.
Nice. How do I switch? Oh, there we go.
Stacked, whatever.
Yeah.
It doesn't look that much better than your yo-yo.
It is. Well, it goes a little further.
Like a little further.
But you also, the yo-yo, you need to worry about it, like, coming back. You can get hit in that, like...
Oh, it's tricky with the snakes, too. You can hit the snake twice.
Exactly. Oh, the first boss. Man, ooh. This is very nostalgic. Wow. I wonder if the fire can reach him.
Are you just perfectly safe anytime you're on the sides?
Nice. I think so.
Oh, yeah, you burnt that snake.
Ooh.
So you can only hurt him when his mouth is open?
Yeah. Oh. Bastard. Oh. Oh. Tried to fake me out. I think with the yo-yo, I have to get one further in, too. It's the crazy.
You feel like don't keep there with him?
Yeah.
What? No. He would hurt you all the time, wouldn't he? Crazy talk.
Well, maybe not. Let's see. Yeah, no, I don't think it works. You can jump over the fire.
Oh, wow. That's some high-level play.
Yeah, look at his bones.
That's awesome. I'd make a soup from him.
Great victory music.
Yeah.
Maga says, oh, it's really like Zelda, even boss fights. Yeah, totally. Yeah, and it's like they're just dungeons. Back to the world, Matt.
Did this game come out in Laco? And if it did it have a way better name than Star Tropics?
Yeah, it looks like it did in a couple years later.
Sweet.
1992, yeah. Sounds like it was still just called Star Tropics. Great, it's a great name.
It's a great name. And the sequel is an even better name. Star Tropics 2 Zoda's Revenge.
That's true.
That's a cool
Babu.
One. Babu! Travel through time and meet all kinds of fun historical figures.
Dr. Mike, he has a submarine called the Subsea. The ID code to start the engine of Subsea is 1492.
Oh, I just gotta remember that.
I memorized it.
Oh, perfect.
In the game, I think. I seem to have memorized it in as an item.
It'd be very funny if it expected you to still memorize it and it just wrote that in the game.
I wouldn't be surprised with the way it gets you to get a code from your instruction book.
Yeah,
this is the guy. This is the guy that makes you get the code.
Oh, yeah. It's like a Rob the Robot.
His name is Navcom.
Hi, Navcom.
Put in the code. Oh, yeah. See, like, I never just knew. Yeah, like, I think I got lost pretty early on in this game after this.
Well, I don't where.
Like, that's all very clear to me. I remember playing that probably multiple times.
Getting up to the submarine?
Yeah, and then and I definitely remember doing this. Yeah, like, driving around in the submarine. And I'm sure I got to the next area. Oh, it's a fun dolphin. Kwee-kwee. Kwee-kay, kwee-kwee, quark. No, she's Navcom can translate. Please find my son. He has disappeared. May I promise her to find the boy? May I promise her to find her boy dolphin? Yes.
I'll find your boy dolphin.
It's a promise.
That's so cool.
Yeah, let's explore this lighthouse. Whoa. Who's this? Hello, I maintain the lighthouse. So you're looking for a boy dolphin. Sorry, but I've not seen him.
I think this is...
Who?
That Robert Eggers movie, isn't it?
Oh, the lighthouse. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure they were looking for a boy dolphin.
A boy dolphin.
Please visit my wife at our south house. She enjoys company. Whoa, that's when the twist happens in that movie.
There's stingers. That's the twist.
Oh, and murderers.
Oh man, they're gonna eat.
But
Mike.
It's all they're all in that character's mind.
Wow.
The lighthouse keeper, even Mike. This whole game is in that character's mind.
That's intense.
Don't remember what his name was.
No.
But he's yeah. It's all in his mind.
He's mad. He's just gone mad.
Oh man, I am so tired today. I'm at chapter 2, though.
You gotta shove some bananas in your ears. That potassium.
No, that... I think... Oh, wait. I think that when you're on the world map, you can just press start at any time or select. I don't know which it is. And it tells you what chapter you're on. That's nice.
You mean what chapter?
I guess I can't land on... beaches.
Huh. You need to have a boat dock?
We have a boat dock. There's the boat dock up there. So I can't get in there. Let's keep exploring.
What's the difference between the two colors of ocean?
I'm pretty sure that's a barrier that I can't go to, yeah.
Can't go to the blue ocean.
Yeah. This goes on for quite a while, though.
It really does. Are you sure you're going the right way?
I was just going to try to explore, like, the barrier, but...
Oh, yeah.
It seems huge.
It does seem very big.
Like, it can't be infinite, right? Can it?
Can it?
Is it just somehow going to do the infinite scroll thing?
That would be insane, especially if you have to go all the way back and it like makes you cover all the ground.
No. Yeah, never mind. It looks like it's pretty...
Oh,
I think it was just doing an infinite scroll thing.
Interesting.
But then where the hell do I go? It's all a dead end. At least this music's awesome. Oh, what's this? Is this something? No. Like, I'm pretty sure I have to get, like, a power-up or something.
From the first island, or...?
Or maybe I already have the ability.
But those fires, you can cut the bushes with your matches or whatever.
Up on... Here, you mean? On land?
Is that are keeping you from passing?
These guys?
Yeah.
I can't... Yeah. Oh, weird. I don't even seem to have any matches anymore. But, I also can't activate them. See those, like little lines in the water? There's, like, little parts, squares that have lines? I know in those you can, like, go underneath. And you can come up on the other side of them. Like, they're connecting.
Oh, right. So there's not just holes through the land here already that you could just drive your sub... Could you, like, drive your submarine under that mountain that's there? Into the next square?
What's this? Oh, yep.
Aha!
Okay. Weird.
Yeah, they don't make it very...
But I think I do need a power to go underwater.
Oh, yeah. You probably get that from rescuing the boy dolphin.
Oh, yeah. That's a boy dolphin power.
Diving.
I've ever heard of one. Welcome, welcome. It's so seldom my husband and I get visitors. Oh, that's the guy's husband. This is their south house.
For a boy dolphin.
Yeah, from boy dolphin story. I've not seen him. But early this morning, I saw a bottle on the beach. I wonder if it's a clue to the lost dolphin. you sound insane, but... That's to be quite a coincidence, but okay, lady. Somehow, I have a feeling she's right. I don't know how to get to the bottle, though. How did you get there, lady? Maybe the ship can go through things.
It is a magical trans-dimensional ship.
Go through...
I think it's... I don't know. There's probably other routes you can take up towards the top. Or can you go get the... Oh yeah, Alex agrees with me from before. Go through the mountains.
Where's that?
Go back to the first area of this.
Through here?
Yeah. Although, where the hell can you go now? Underwater through the mountains. I don't actually know what he means anymore.
Yeah, underwater. Like I was saying, you can go... Oh, I think he means down here. It's weird that I can go through there. But he means go through here and through here, but I don't know how to go through underwater. Like, I don't think I have the ability, do I?
You're probably pushing all the buttons.
There's only two buttons, yeah. I mean, they start and select, but I do that.
Those blue patches.
You mean like the ones with the squiggly lines, or are there other blue patches that I'm missing? Yeah, like I think there's an you get a power up for it.
Don't we need to? Where do we get this power up?
That I don't know. Can I walk through mountains? I don't think so. No. That'll block me. She told me to get that bottle, but.
Yeah, what if you walk along the beach? Does something pop up towards the end?
No, I tried, but. Oh, well, secret passage.
Secret passage. Man, that would be real tough.
Totally. Yeah, like I was just pressing A and B and walking and trying every direction. So, I guess that's how you find it.
Right.
You got a bottle. There's nothing in the bottle. You read it. Suspense.
Yeah. Oh, are you going to... You do get to choose?
Help! Captured by evil aliens. Tell my nephew to use 1776 Dr. J.
Oh, man.
Memorized it.
You memorized the code.
That's why he trusted in me.
Is that the upgrade that's going to let you dodge?
I read the... message again. Oh, probably, yeah. 1776, of course. Yeah, it's weird. Yeah, it took a turn there all of a sudden. Captured by aliens. It's just like... Help! I'm captured by aliens! Come save me!
Yeah. The whole mission is different now. He's not only just missing.
That's the 90s for you.
Oh, yeah.
Like I said, but it looks really cool. Yeah, it's a great game.
Totally is.
I own this on cartridge. I think from the way back in the day.
Wow.
I remember selling a few of those of my cartridges when I was a kid and regretting it. But I remember specifically keeping Star Tropics, yeah.
Wow.
Alright, so I guess this is a new dungeon. I'm gonna save.
Oh,
those guys are bastards.
What was it?
Oh, God. Okay.
Wow. Did you just have to jump them?
Oh, you probably can. Yeah.
Yeah.
I think you can hit them too. But especially. Oh, wow. I only have 30 strikes with this spell.
Man, I don't remember. Shit. I thought it was unlimited.
Me too. Because, like, why is your yo-yo so unbreakable?
I mean, because it's got an iron chain.
Wow, Alex says, we played this at my Waldo-themed birthday party in grade 2.
Ooh.
That goes back.
Okay, so were you dressed up?
It is quite a lot of... It's a loaded sentence. A lot going on there.
Birthday party.
What?
Was everyone dressed as Waldo? Were you just trying to find a person?
I don't think there was much to it. It was like...
You just had to...
Waldo theme. Like, it was Waldo decorations and Waldo cake.
But like, what is Waldo theme? Like, it's just striped red and white with blue jeans?
It was like Waldo stuff.
Like,
Waldo was a character.
He was a character, that's true.
He was a character.
Oh, they played Pin the Glasses on Waldo.
Oh, there you go, that's good stuff.
That's a fun game. Oh man, you're so close to dead.
Yeah. Oh man, I gotta have a heart. Like I said, do enemies respawn? I'm not sure. Can you even go back?
No,
things check. Whoa. The door's closed. Oh, shit.
Well, now you're a ghost.
Let's see where it puts me. Oh, nice. That's pretty generous.
It would be really fun to have a Waldo-themed birthday party.
These guys are bastards. I'm not even fighting them.
The weird cross thing? Oh, the things on these pads.
No, that weird cross. The starfish thing that was flying around.
I don't even remember. Huh. All you know is they're bastards.
Love how you can attack in the air.
Totally. Like, we've already gotten three of his Smash Brothers moves, matches, baseball bat, and yo-yo. I guess he's a little too close to Ness. That would be
That's one of the bigger problems. And he just, honestly, the biggest problem is that he doesn't have much personality like, at all.
He does in the second game when he helps Antony and Cleopatra, and he finds the Yeti.
Oh, that's... I mean, does he, though?
I don't remember.
The game sounds like it has lots of personality, but he's still just Mike Jones. Like, it's even just the most generic name.
They should have named him something like Phineas Jones.
Totally. And, you know, it made him... I don't know.
Instead of good at baseball, he's actually the son of... I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know how they could make him unique, but just more memorable, like Mario or Samus.
What makes Mario memorable, if you really think of it? I have no idea.
He's so weird. He's like he's an Italian plumber that's saving, like...
Mike Jones is a teenage baseball star that's saving his uncle
from America. Yeah, he's like the most generic. He's like the American teen baseball star.
Mario is also definitely American. He's from Brooklyn.
Well, he's, I don't know, he's also, yeah. So I don't know how to open this door. Oh, wait, there must be a switch somewhere. There we go. And there's obviously just way more history to pull from with Mario.
Totally.
You got a voice, you got...
There wasn't at this point.
Well, no, but I'm still talking about like putting him in Smash Bros.
They should just make him an Echo Fighter of Ness.
Oh, shit, that'd be awesome. I was always under of the opinion that they should have included lots of Echo Fighters.
Totally. Yeah, just have as many skins and dumb things.
He's been on my one of my most wanted lists for. It's like basically since Brawl.
It's true. He's less likely than Goku to end up in there, though. I'd say. He's less likely than, like, John Cena to end up in Smash Brothers.
No.
It's very
unlikely because of how little attention Sakurai has given him and how little. Fans don't even seem to really care.
Nope.
He doesn't have that much of a. That's the problem. Yeah. Even like somebody like Pit from Kid Icarus, you know, at least he's got like a
better than Kid Icarus.
In Smash Bros. He would basically just be Ness. Like he has almost no personality whatsoever.
That's true, but for sure. But just the fact that they kept going with the Kid Icarus, yet they stopped on this one.
They kept going because of Smash Bros. That's honestly the main reason why I want Mike Jones represented in Smash Bros.
Right.
So that it has a chance of coming back.
That would be so good. What the hell are you trying to do?
I'm looking for like a secret passage or something. I don't know what else to do. Oh, there we go. There it is.
Oh, man.
I didn't realize it was, like, that visible.
Telegraph?
This is the kind of game, it seems like. That's all I did to find the secret passage on the world map.
You gotta go top right. Whoa. I'm, the more I think about it, the more I like the idea of a Waldo-themed birthday party in this day.
Not in a pandemic
world. It'd be great
world.
To be a party where you got, like, the party takes place at, like, the Fringe or something, and you pay someone to dress up as Waldo, and everyone at your party has to find Waldo at the Fringe. And whoever finds him gets something. That'd
it's
be
bullshit
so good.
That it takes a number off when you even when you miss.
Yeah, it's true.
That'd be amazing, especially with like a huge crowd after the pandemic's over.
Totally.
Yeah, just having like a giant.
Like, you just have, and You disperse like yellow toques or red toques to random people as you walk beforehand too, so there's people who sort of look like him.
Yeah, exactly. Have a few bonus characters like the wizard and the dog.
And a pile of books.
That'd be great. Oh man. Is this a boss?
Is this a boss? Those things spitting at you are a real son of a gun.
Can't tell if it's multiple things or just one bastard. Oh man.
I think there's two bastards.
Okay, I gotta save. Now.
Oh yeah.
I haven't actually tested it to see if it's working. Oh, that was a long way back though. Shit. I should have saved before that.
Ooh, wow.
That's bad.
Oh well, you'll be so much better at it now.
Where is that? Oh, there. Does it change where it is? Or did I just never switch? Never step on that spot. Michael says, the good thing is with Nintendo Online, you can always save. Yeah, that's true. Oh!
Rewind in the Nintendo Online, right?
I might as well just... Oh, wait. Actually, I don't know how to...
If in Nintendo Online, you could rewind as well, right?
Oh, I just realized I'm not using the right keyboard.
Oh no, wrong computer. It's gotten too complicated.
Boom, boom. Boom, boom. Yeah, I'm still playing on an emulator where I can save. I'm just stupid.
I wish this thing had rewind capabilities. That'd be really nice. Did you even use your bat at all?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay.
I used it against those stupid starfish in that one room.
Oh,
it was pretty useful, actually.
Right.
Those things are the worst.
Yeah.
There we go. Look, now it says save state. That's good. That means I'm on the right computer.
Perfect. You have half a hit left. This is the exact amount of health you want to have.
This, how much I had last time?
I think so, yeah, the exact same spot. It's really, really rare at giving you health, like, health back.
Damn, I hate those starfish bastards. Man. Can't remember how to reload, though. I'm just going to look at this quickly. Whoops, whoops, whoops.
Whoops, labels. Oh, no. It's got to be, like, shift F1, right?
I think it's just... Yeah. Damn it, I hate those things so much. Okay, let's do this. What? Wait, what? Oh no, what's happening now? What?
I don't know.
Oh, it worked there. Weird. Maybe it just took a second to load in.
Interesting.
Nice. Yeah, that's what we're talking about. Save there.
Those guys do. Then.
Well, at least I don't have half a heart.
Yeah, you can get hit twice. I think that these cross guys can only move diagonally, right? Like they are. They're like bishops.
Yeah, they're awful. Awful hell creatures.
Ah! He fooled you.
Oh, what a bastard.
It's true.
Whew. Oh.
That sucks. Oh, could you, because you can attack while you're in the air, could you not kill them as you're like coming at them?
You totally can, yeah. I've done it before, I just wasn't quick enough there. Oh, you bastards.
Oh, man.
There we go. You're quick enough. Didn't even bother you.
Oh wow, this is so efficient this time. Oh.
Oh no, oops.
Oh.
Yeah, it's pretty brutal. Like these, you have to be so, you have to like, yeah, be so correct on the timing of the jumps on those things.
And I think they get more specific and annoying the further you get in.
Probably.
Where you have to jump like over a sequence of disappearing ones.
Oh yeah, definitely. I don't think that's even that laid in.
Oh, that was so close. Or can that guy not get you at the end?
I don't know, yeah.
Oh gosh.
Oh. Now I'm gonna save.
Yes.
Sweet health.
Yeah.
Oh, I was trying to read some stuff.
That's your mistake. You're gonna take your damage.
Okay, bat time.
Oh yeah, these guys.
Oh god, they're awful. Oh god.
I can't believe you didn't get that one ahead of time.
Totally. Oh. Yeah. I think this is a boss. It's like boss music.
Have you saved?
Yeah. Okay. Oh, wow. That was nice. Wow. Wow.
That went perfectly
save there, yeah. I think that is, or maybe that's just the boss like tormenting you.
Oh, and you're gonna eat the. You mean like all those things that look like Zoras?
Yeah, I think that. But I think it was just one. But maybe, yeah, maybe you're right. Maybe it's multiples.
I don't even know.
Oh shit! Come
but
on.
These things in theory.
They're, yeah, but I'll probably hurt myself more trying to kill them. Oh.
Whoa, two switches.
I think the switches do open. Yeah, just open them. Okay. I don't know what I got. A snowman?
I don't know what that's good for. Huh, doesn't seem like a boss here.
Yeah, there's no music, but the fish is back.
The fish is back.
It's the boy dolphin.
Well, no. Does he need help?
He's screaming for help 24 hours a day.
So, how come he can speak English, but his mother could only speak dolphinese?
What do I do? Can I bat these bat you, do you think?
Oh, I hope so.
I don't think I can. Oh, no.
I was going to say he runs forward at a certain point.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
You should be able to be an assist trophy in Smash Brothers.
Totally.
Octopod.
Sun dolphin? No, it doesn't mean
the octopod. It's a baby boy.
Oh, come on now. owe me. I might as well find out after this. I can always just...
Yeah. Oh. It's going to be really hard to memorize this boss fight on one hit. I mean, you could also just save now. And, like, really...
Oh, that's true.
Can you accidentally... Oh. off and like kill yourself that way too?
I don't think so. Maybe
that would really suck.
Shit, I feel like we're ready for him. Is he gonna go on, I don't know, is he gonna go on this one? No, this one. Yes. Oh, I still only got one hit in.
Kill that son of a gun.
Oh come on. Do it now. Do it. Oh, that bass, that was impossible, that one. Wow, what a bastard. Oh, man. This is hard. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, right. I was going to see what happens when I load it so long. Oh, never mind. I just died instantly anyway.
Perfect.
Let's see how far back this is. I mean, I basically only have two hits by this metric. Like,
it's true.
Nope. I think that still gives me two hits, I think, for this trick.
So
but what's this?
I don't know.
Secret.
What do you get?
Oh no. Oh, better be good. Better be full health or I don't. Oh, that's a potion. I think that's pretty good.
How do you use it?
That I don't know. And I basically need it now anyway, so.
But you could be more careful getting to this potion if in a previous or in a future.
Totally,
attempt.
Yeah. Oh god. Not this room. I don't know. Select doesn't seem to do it. And start just does that. Oh, wait, never mind. Start does. I can go to this menu. Magic items.
Magic items?
And it gives me full health. That's pretty great. I like that you use it on the pause menu.
Yeah.
You just freeze everything.
So you can
oh, shit.
Yeah, games so often make you have to put yourself in danger to heal yourself.
Yes. Damn it. Oh, God.
It's
weird. There's like a... It's like you turn and then you move. It's like you turn and pause for a second every time you like want to go into a new direction.
Right.
God, I hate those guys so much.
Alex, oh, yeah, you read that before, that you're supposed to use the bat on the octopus?
I did, yeah. Oh, God.
Oh, fuck.
I should have saved, damn it. Oh, well, I guess I can still do better than all that.
Totally.
That was terrible. Okay. Oh, is it like... Do I have to kill like a specific bat, but I don't know which one it is?
Oh, is it?
I think so. Because the first time I killed just the first one.
And then the door pops, right?
Hmm. Nice. right. And now, should I take the risk?
I'm going all the way back or saving?
Okay, I guess I'm going to save anyway. So yeah, it's worth the risk of not using my potion. Because I have one hit, basically.
Right.
And then I can press, although... Never mind, I have zero hits, so I have to use my potion.
And being forced into action is the...
Oh, and what's... let me see, do I have... that's where my snowman is.
Oh.
I wonder what that is.
What does it do?
I have no idea.
Use it on the boss. Whatever. Or if you can't even use it.
Ah, what a bastard. Alex says it freezes the enemies.
Oh. Huh. Like, if you use the snowman on the boss when he's right in front of your face.
Yeah, that's probably very useful on this boss. Yeah. Wait, oh, shit. Yeah, that was fast enough.
Snowman! Oops. Oh, wow.
Oh, I don't have my bat anymore, though.
Oh, you use that when you die? Shit.
I beat the like shit out of him, though. The yo-yo almost seems better. Because you can, like, hit him multiple times. And you can hit him while you're jumping.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Yeah!
We're gonna have some calamari tonight?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I guess, like, he could call in, his submarine friend.
Huh.
Mike Jones.
Oh, yeah, or his whale boy friend, or his dolphin boy.
In Smash Bros. Yeah, I don't know how big a character the boy dolphin becomes. But submarine guy. Or, like, he could even just call in the submarine. Like, that could be one of
his
moves. That's
true. But that might be his final smash, though. Or maybe bananas in his ears is his final smash.
Oh, yeah.
It's just, he loses it.
All right. Yeah, translate. He is the boy dolphin. Yeah, I got that. He is thanking us for saving him. Let's signal his mother. The mother dolphin? We'll never forget your kindness. Now we must help you. Please follow me. Please follow me.
Please follow me? Where are you following her?
Oh, they're showing us how to dive under multiple rocks.
Oh.
To get to this ocean. We'll never forget your kindness. Good luck. Nice. Saving my data. Number 3, storm and calm. Suddenly it gets dark and stormy on the ocean. The sea tosses subsea. Oh no! I actually do remember this. I definitely got to here.
Where you get shipwrecked?
Yeah.
Right.
And I remember saving the dolphins, and
isn't there a whole new tribe of island people you have to... this is... Like, it's sort of familiar.
Yeah, like, I probably only got here a couple times.
Right.
Whereas I played that beginning a million times. Yeah, it looks like new. You look tired. Drink some coconut milk. Nice. Feel great. Go to Miracola and find your wrecked ship.
Miracola?
It's a new cola island.
It sounds great. It's even better than the original Cola Island.
Would I have to go through a cave, I guess?
Maybe some spelunking?
More cave. I don't think we're going to get to that part where the where he sticks bananas in his ears, unfortunately.
That's like the end of the game, isn't it?
I think so. I couldn't actually... I was trying to find the part like in the story where it happens. Right. I couldn't. I know it does somewhere. But right. Then at the very end of the game, there's like a montage of events that happened. and the very last picture is him sticking bananas in his ears.
Beautiful.
And that's what I was recreating in my Instagram video. Oh, what's this? What is that? Oh, it's like Caltrops.
Caltrops are such a weird thing. Like, I don't think they would be my first weapon of choice ever.
No.
They would, like barely slow someone down.
They have, like, shoes. One function, and then you have to be, like, an expert at them to be able to get them to do the one kind of crappy thing they do.
Yeah, which is just hurt someone's feet.
Yeah. If you're amazing, I guess you can, like, trap, like, or, well, I mean, they can pull it off, but you can, like, make them fall down and have to get something off their feet.
Oh, yeah.
But,
or make them fall down into more Caltrops.
I guess. Oh, wait, what? Alex says that's literally the end boss. Who's the end boss?
I don't know.
We go into Caltrops bananas? After that.
Caltrops is the end boss. It's a guy named Caltrops.
These guys are annoying. Just kind of have to wait for them, and if you don't. If you try to go after them yourself, you just get screwed over. I don't know what these Caltrops are good for. They seem pretty terrible. Oh, I thought I could get through there fast enough. I'm not doing great.
Yeah, that's cool. It takes two tries to get through these dungeons anyways.
Oof, yeah. Oof. Wow. Pretty generous with the health. I'll save there. Wow, those are great enemies. Skull chickens.
What are they? Oh, man. Their bodies are so big. Yeah, they're freaking terrifying.
Oh shit. Oh damn it. I didn't think this last chicken would be a problem. Oh. Second, yeah.
Whoa.
What the hell just what? Oh wow.
I don't know. Just black.
Huh. Oh no. Whoops. Too many computers and stuff in front of me here. Alright, I'll just get back to the game here in 1 second. I shall give up on what I was trying to do there.
Never try things.
Alex says that's literally it says the bananas. Oh!
Yeah.
Sticking the bananas in your ears. So it happens right before the end boss, you mean?
Well.
Ah. But then, oh, interesting. Okay, well, because I know, isn't there a part where you can walk around and, like, talk to people, but you have to take the bananas out of your ears or something?
What?
There's screenshots of people saying, like, oh, you still have bananas in your ears or something?
Oh, weird.
I don't know. Oh, God. What's with this dark room? What am I missing here?
Have you? No, you don't get any, like, torches anywhere in this dungeon.
Damn it. Damn it. Those are such great enemies. Shit. Shit. Holy crap. Oh, bastards. Oh, I hate these guys.
They're real scumbags. The little ones or the big ones?
The little ones, but the big ones are being very annoying right now, too. That went pretty bad, dude. Oh, it did show me there, the... Oh,
like
what?
Second. Oh, God.
Well, I've saved right after I beat that room. I get it. I don't know how to open it, though. Unless I jump on the switches.
Right.
But I can't do that in the dark.
No.
Must need some kind of item.
Or do you have to memorize it?
No, I bet you I need like a
torch.
Zelda-esque.
Gotta
give me
the
milk. Give me the coconut milk. Yes. Sweet coconut milk. Huh. That's weird. That seemed like a alternate exit or something. Because it's not out of the... It's not where I wanted to go.
Yeah.
Well, I don't even know. There's not a lot of... like, what was... I don't even know what All Game was. Maybe that was back in the day. But not a lot of reviews for it in general.
Oh, yeah.
It's not on Metacritic or anything. But I guess... I don't know if this is like a new review or not, but they gave it 4 to 4.5 stars, and they found it to be a bit derivative of Zelda, but very much an excellent game.
Wow. There you go.
In Nintendo Power 1997, they called Star Tropics the 64th best game of all time.
That sounds right to me.
Yeah.
I think I'd never put it in the top 50, but 64th is right.
Also, yeah, there's in that, like, in the montage I was talking about at the end of the game that shows you all the moments, there's a spot that shows you the, like, one of the shots is of a instruction manual with water all over it.
Really?
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Hey, Tiny Observer. How's it going?
More games should end with a little retrospective of everything you've done over the course of the game.
Totally. Like Earthbound style?
Yeah.
I mean, Earthbound was genius about it.
This is all the people you touched.
Yeah. Earthbound was amazing because you actually had a photographer show up mid-game constantly and take pictures, so you kind of knew it was coming.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know what else really to say about Star Tropics. That's about it. It's a weird little Nintendo game that they've forgotten about. I think we'll play Zelda's Revenge in... I think
totally.
You should do it in like... both do it. I'd like to play it too, actually.
Oh, yeah.
But yeah, Forgotten Curiosities or something.
Yeah, totally.
I feel like it totally qualifies. Because like, I forget about it half the time.
Yeah. Oh, man, I loved it. And I played it as an adult, so I feel like my love for it is fairly founded. Like, it just plays better than this one.
Right. That would make sense. I just didn't even know about it as a kid.
No. Because I think it's super late, Nintendo.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, so we'll definitely play that at some point. For sure. But we got another game coming up. You came right before our break, Tiny Observer, but we're going to be back with Super Castlevania 4.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we're going to get spooky.
Get spooky, kill a vampire.
Yeah. So stay tuned.
Oh, oh.
stream. Ooh, we're back. But we're no longer playing Star Fox, Star Tropics, Star Fox, Ipics. Play some Castlevania. So sorry, one second here. Actually, you want to change the title there, Grimps? I'll change the game. Totally. We are now playing Super Castlevania 4. Which has got to be good because it has the word super in it. Mm-hmm. That's why the Super Nintendo is so great. Totally. And I'm having a banana. I'm eating the rest of my banana. I'm done sticking them in my ears. There. Alright. In my mouth. Stick those bananas in my mouth. The actor said to the bishop. See, that doesn't work as well. So. Yeah, true. Not. Oh, whoops. Thanks, Tiny Observer. I had you muted.
Oh, man.
We're talking about Super Castlevania 4 now.
Yeah.
It's spooky. It's it came out December 4th, 1991.
Yeah, it was basically a launch game for the Super Nintendo. Like, right. Not quite, but it may as well have been.
But was it in Japan? No.
I don't know.
Because it came out October 31st in Japan, 1991.
Yeah, that might have been a launch game then.
And I'm pretty sure it came out in October. So, I don't know. It doesn't seem to say it here, so I don't think it was. It's on the Super NES Classic. We played a bunch of Castlevania games on the show before. It's not one of the most influential or biggest.
Nope.
But it's still pretty beloved.
It's got a great look to it.
I think the only Super Nintendo Castlevania. I'm gonna go on a limb and say that.
There's also Castlevania Dracula X.
That was just in Japan.
No, that came out here too.
Right. We talked about that a couple weeks ago.
Yeah, it's very bad.
The bad version came out here.
Yeah.
The only good Super Nintendo.
Yeah, totally.
Dracula. It's got some Mode 7 graphics.
It's got, yeah, I remember the clock tower has some insane Mode 7 stuff in this game.
Yeah.
Because it was a new Super Nintendo game. They're like, let's use this new technology as much as we humanly can.
Yeah, it's got to be flashy.
Yeah.
I mean, to be honest, there's not too much to say about this either.
Right.
It's just kind of a classic Castlevania game. Like there's, you know, like the a couple things like they there's early design documents that show the player character in modern clothes because the setting hadn't been decided.
Huh.
Many times.
They eventually get there, don't they?
I think so. Maybe. Yeah. Some of the GS ones take place in the future.
Yeah. You get like a gun eventually.
Yeah. The director loved Castlevania 1 the most, and so he he kind of started it as a remake of Castlevania 1.
Neat.
I can't remember what I was going to say.
Perfect.
Oh, and they just wanted it to be less frustrating. That's what I was going to say.
Oh, yeah.
Based on the first three NES games.
It is weird because I do remember this game also being very frustrating.
Totally. Yeah.
But, yeah. At least it's beatable, probably.
They consider doing the branching stages of Castlevania 3. There's, like, multiple paths you can take through the game, but they decided not to do that. Yeah, let's just start playing.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. Can't remember what my name was in the other.
Oh, was it?
Oh, whoops. Oh,
Bacteria.
Oh. I can't remember how to do this, so my name is Morpheme.
Those are Fs?
I think so.
Oh, wow. I thought they were Ps.
Yeah, it's very fancy writing.
Fancy, definitely the word I'd use for it.
Yeah, you got a classic whip. You're Belmont in this game. You're just Simon Belmont.
Yeah.
Pretty great. Yeah, like you said, it looks great. The background's awesome.
Totally.
Laka loves this game. He says this is an awesome game. He voted for this game.
Simon is super well animated as well.
Yeah.
Like, everything's really good looking.
Have you ever beaten this game, Laco? Remember we were talking about this earlier. I never have. I played it on the Wii when it came out for that.
Right.
But it was too hard.
It's a real brutal game.
I probably would have done it if it came out for the Wii U or later, because I would have had save states.
Well, like, we're so used to playing like the Symphony or the Metroidvania Symphony or Castlevania games, and those are very easy games.
It's true. They just take like patience.
Yeah.
Like you just Whereas this is repetitive.
With what's it even called? The one Rondo of Blood. As I'm playing that. I mean, you're good. All you ever have to do is beat one level at a time. So you just have to be good in, like, 5-minute chunks.
That's true, yeah. Yeah, I guess this game, that was the deal with this game, too.
I think so, yeah.
But
that's not unreasonable.
I think you still have lives, though. And, like, I think you still get game over and sent back to the start.
That's rough. And there's limited continues.
I think so.
I'm glad we live in a world where continues aren't a thing anymore.
It's true.
Like, I just don't have time for that.
Where developers needed to make games, like, worth more money. Like, the value for them be more, so they just made them way harder.
Yeah, we'll just make it take them 6 months to beat.
Exactly. Rather than... If it was easy, it would take them, like, an hour.
Yeah. Yeah, because those games were short.
Exactly. I think Star Tropics, there's, like, a long play I was looking at that it was, like, 2 hours.
Oh.
So this is what it takes to beat it, basically.
Yeah. Probably by someone who's pretty good at it, though, still. But...
Yeah, exactly. But yeah, the game feels great. The music's fantastic.
Sweet.
The sound effects are great. It's just a great Castlevania game.
Yeah, it's kind of the last one of this style, isn't it? I guess.
Yeah, kind of. Like you said, Rondo of Blood.
Yeah.
Dracula X.
Those are around the same time, I guess. Oh no, this is 91. Never mind.
And
this is actually...
Chronicles too. When did the Genesis one.
That's true. So they did kind of keep going.
But they're all, like you said, though, they're all kind of around the same time.
Yeah. And they never had the notoriety of this game again.
oven, at least.
It's true.
Until Symphony of the Night.
That's true. Like, we played Chronicles and stuff.
Yeah.
And we played Rondo of Blood not that long ago. Rondo of Blood is definitely more, like, historic. But
totally. That's true.
Chronicles and this, they're just, yeah, they're of that time of just that 16-bit Castlevania. Oh, shit! I didn't realize you had to hold it down there. 16-bit Castlevania adventures.
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't actually know how to make save states in the emulator. I forgot to look at that.
What is it? SNES 9 times? That's the only SNES emulator I know.
No, I don't think so. Maybe.
And that is also from like 20 years ago. So it might be. Emulators.
It might be.
Huh. Interesting. Because if it is that, then it's the F keys are either load and then shift plus the F keys is save. But it could go the other direction.
But which F key is the problem?
Yeah. Yeah, that's a great question.
Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit. Oh.
Too bad. Can you, in this game, can you wiggle your whip all over the place?
Yep. Do the old wiggle whip.
It's a great thing. It's always bad, but it's such a great
thing. Yeah, it's never actually useful, but it's awesome that it exists. Yeah. And I guess it's good for the bats and stuff. And the
You can't do that in Smash Brothers, can you?
Oh, yeah, you totally can.
And is it useful?
I mean, in theory, yeah. Like, you can, you could use it to, like, keep a combo going and like pull characters towards you and lead into other moves.
Interesting. So it's more useful in Smash Brothers than it is in this game.
Like they wouldn't get like pulled towards you like a whip, like a, you know, they just kind of get knocked around and you might be able to like combo it into another move.
Right.
In theory, like it'd be like a pro level.
Which I definitely.
Who? I did it.
Good job.
I definitely made it a few levels in, though. I remember fighting a werewolf.
I think the werewolf is the first boss.
Yeah. So maybe I just made it one level in.
But that might also just be Rondo of Blood where the werewolf was the first boss. I can't remember. I think I fought a Frankenstein in this game.
Oh.
Yeah.
So spooky.
There's no spookier monster than a Frankenstein.
And a werewolf? Man. Sounds like the Monster Mash.
Yeah. Then you fight a Hollow Man.
Oh no. Kevin Bacon?
Yeah. Rapey Kevin Bacon.
Invisible rapey Kevin Bacon.
Yeah.
The scariest of all the monsters. Oh, shit. Oh, man. Oh, God. Now you kind of used the wiggle whip there.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, God. Flying horse heads.
They're the worst kind. This is like the sci-fi version of The Godfather.
Oh.
That part where Michael Corleone gets haunted by the flying horse heads in his bed.
Sent by Dracula.
Yeah.
Ooh, that secret I found.
That'd be a great movie. Dracula meets the Godfather.
Totally. Tiny bit of rest. What does the enemy bar represent here? I think just the boss.
Yeah, but when like, you get to the boss, it shows his health.
Yeah, it's just weird. It's weird that it shows it through the whole level.
Yeah.
I think there's an enemy coming, and he's at full health.
If you're fighting an enemy that doesn't die in one hit, I think it does show about their health too, doesn't it?
What?
Like, if you hit an enemy that doesn't die in one hit, doesn't it bring their health up on that
bar?
Oh,
shit. That was a hole? Wow. I'm just going to look at a... Make a save state here. Save game position. Oh, it doesn't say.
No. Even worse.
That's annoying.
It really is.
Oh, no. Well, I didn't do... Oh, no. I don't like this emulator.
It's no SNES 9 times.
Oh, yeah.
I'll tell you what.
Oh, shit. What is with those things? I guess you don't want to step on them at all.
Fall away. It doesn't look like they fall away, even.
You just kind of... They basically do, but they just flip and make you fall through them.
Oh, yeah. That is crazy. I'm surprised the Medusas are after you so early on.
Yeah, that's cruel.
Yeah.
Oh, no. Oh, God. Why didn't that kill him? Multiple hits. Oh, God. The whip sometimes just feels awful in Castlevania games.
Yeah.
Where they're just like slightly above you, above it, and like they're in that blind spot.
Yeah, it's true. Yeah. You try and do the wiggly whip into them, but it never happens.
Yeah, exactly. You need the diagonal whip.
Yeah.
It's always brutal when there's no diagonal whip. Okay, there's one. Oh, God. Oh, Medusas. Settle down, Medusas. Whoa.
Oh, those ghosts.
They're annoying. Annoying ghosts. I think I have to hit. What are they ghosts of? It's true.
Yeah, nothing like any creature I am familiar with.
Yeah, they're weird. They're like.
Maybe they're kittens?
Maybe. Or just cats. I don't know if they're.
Yeah, cats.
Kittens would be really small, I think.
Right.
But, maybe just little gremlins or something.
Probably.
Here we go. Is this the enemy? Wow. Yeah, this is the enemy. I'm hurting. I see him finally doing some damage to that health bar.
At long last. What is this guy? Man on a horse skeleton? Whoa. He kicked his ass. Oh!
He's still going. Wow. He's still going. Oh, wait. No, he's dead.
Now he's dead. You can think of his bones. Oh,
that's
cool.
I can whip down.
What good? Oh, it looks cool. I like the way you do with your other arm when you whip down. Yeah.
Oh.
Congratulations.
I did the thing. Thanks, Tiny Observer.
Yeah. Oh, right. It's got a weird overworld map.
Yeah. Looks like Donkey Kong Country.
Totally.
But I don't think you choose levels on it. It just shows you like where you are on it.
Right.
Wow, the crazy bushman.
That's what you call me.
God, that's annoying. Ooh, these spiders. I hate these spiders. I should take it. I should make another.
Oh, yeah. Better save than sorry.
Oh, man. We're just on the puns today.
Oh, yeah.
That's what happens when we get tired.
True. It's the cleverest thing we can come up with.
Ah, okay, cool. This is a spooky place. Where the hell am I? It's weird. This one's not really like...
You're just like, in the mountains.
Yeah, like, when do you get to Castlevania? Or is there a Castlevania? Yeah.
Or was that a town?
What?
Where was the first level?
Just a village?
I don't know, but I did. There was like a drawbridge that I went through. So would suggest that this is all in Castlevania.
Yeah, it's got its own forest.
Like, hellish cavern.
Yeah.
Or Dracula has game night.
Yeah.
Nice. Precious meat. Back in a forest.
That's my favorite Beatles song.
Back in a forest.
At the height of the Cold War between America and the forest.
Oh, shit. Should've just ran. Should've just ran from that crazy armadillo.
True, armadillos under the employ of Dracula are always... Oh,
they're terrifying, yeah. Always run. Oh, man, that was crazy. That kind of seems like the way to do it.
Yeah.
I don't know, the wiggle seems more useful in this one than in most Castlevanias. Say that. Classic whip wiggle.
Yeah,
man, why didn't that become like a dance, like do the Mario?
Oh,
or the Pac-Man, Pac-Man Fever.
Yeah.
Do the whip wiggle.
Do the whip wiggle.
Oh no! Yeah, wow! You see that? I whip wiggled behind me and got that bird, Dracula bird.
I think a lot of places don't want you doing the whip wiggle in public.
No, that's the problem. And do it just by yourself usually, and that's not as fun.
Comfort of your own home, and who wants to dance like that?
Exactly. You just gotta find the right person to whip wiggle with you, I guess.
Exactly.
Or a group of people. Maybe in this online day age, there's gotta be whip wiggle groups.
Totally. Yeah, there's people who are just tickling each other on the internet. Yeah.
Yeah, that was an awesome whip wiggle. I did it below me and got that other bird. It's good against birds. Oh, more meat. I don't even need that meat.
You're so full of meat already.
Whoa, it's Medusas! Oh, wow. She was pretty easy, actually. She hurt me probably as much as the other guy, but killed her faster. Oh, wait, maybe... She wasn't it, though.
They're speedy in this game. Like, if you do good, you finish a boss in like 15 or 20 seconds.
Yeah. Yeah, like that one was super fast. Wow, look at those guys. Like bug demons. Or like gargoyles from the show Gargoyles.
Yeah.
I like the gargoyle that's like a dog.
I don't remember that show, really, to be honest.
I think Phil Lamar is the voice of the lead actor, the lead gargoyle.
I remember the lead gargoyle and then like the smaller green gargoyle just because I had an action figure of him.
Right. You mean like the gremlin-y looking gargoyle?
Yeah,
or the dog?
Yeah. Okay. Or what?
The dog gargoyle, because he was also smaller, but he was
Oh, wow. The spikes, I think, just instantly killed me. I didn't even know there were spikes there. Green Rabbit asked, does the Konami code work in this game?
Oh, you probably, I bet it does, but you probably have to enter it at the main menu. And that's a lot trickier on a controller that doesn't match the controller it was designed for.
Oh, it basically does.
Does it? Oh, okay. You should give it a shot. Maybe it makes your whip the entire length of the screen for your whip wiggling.
Only in the whip wiggle?
Yeah.
But where do I have to enter it?
I'll do some Googling. I'm not finding anything about the Konami code in it, actually.
Well, I'll just try it on the pause screen.
Because there are actual passwords in the game, is the thing.
What's me?
Yeah.
That's right. Because, and then B is over. I mean, I am playing on a PS4. It doesn't totally match, but it's in the same place as the B button is.
On like there's no mention of the Konami code on their cheats page.
Interesting, yeah. They don't seem to do anything there. Green Rabbit says, have we ever watched the Castlevania Netflix show? I think Grimpen has.
Oh, yeah, I've seen the first two seasons. I think there's a third season. Yeah.
I've meant to since the beginning. I'll watch it someday.
Yeah, it's one of the best animes I've watched, because I don't watch anime, really, but... one of the best, so I'm sure that holds up.
Yeah, I've heard only good things, and it's nice. It'd be nice to like be sort of invested in a story with these characters, because
sure.
I've never like the stories.
So many more characters is the problem, and I really don't care about most of them. The second season is worse than the first. The first is kind of like almost a retelling of the beginning of Symphony of the Night.
Yeah, see, that's what I want.
Yeah, the second they introduce Dracula has these like four generals that work underneath him, and it's all their drama.
I mean, that sounds kind of cool still.
It's all right. It's still got lots of gross violence. So that's
I just want to see like, and I want to see Belmonts, and I want to see.
Yeah.
Soma Cruz. I don't know. I don't actually know a lot of Castlevania characters, I guess.
Jonathan and
Uria. Yeah. Something.
Yeah.
The little girl from Rondo Blood.
I think that's Maria.
Oh.
Yeah.
Isn't there an adult Maria too, though?
I don't. Maybe. Maybe she grows up.
Oh.
Yeah.
I guess there's lots of time.
Exactly.
Green Rabbit says the cartoon gives off kind of a Game of Thrones vibe. That's cool.
Uh-huh. And that it's just brutal. Yeah.
Oh, is it like super violent?
Not super violent, but when there is violence, it's very, very intense.
Oh, yeah, Green Rabbit voted for this game, too. It was Lacko and Green Rabbit.
Wow.
Oh, there's Belmonts in the show, right? Or some level of Belmonts?
Yeah.
There must
totally.
Be.
Richter, I think?
is the one who's in it.
Oh.
But I think he's the only one.
I wonder if they're still making more of that.
I think there's a fourth season coming. Yeah, they're pretty successful. Cool. Yeah.
It's crazy how much, like, Castlevania, I think, was their first video game adaptation. And now,
yeah,
they're doing so much video game stuff.
And I think the guy that did the Castlevania Netflix show is doing several of those things.
Well, and then The Witcher, which was like based on the books as well, but I think they got a lot of support from the game communities.
Right.
And I think, yeah, it seems like now they're just all in. Like, they keep announcing more.
Oh, yeah, the guy who did Castlevania is also doing Assassin's Creed, Devil May Cry, and Hyper Light Drifter.
Oh, wow. That's crazy.
All for Netflix. Yeah.
Yeah. And then there's the Resident Evil show.
Yeah.
And, like, there's been other announcements, too.
Isn't there a Monster Hunter show coming? Or was there a movie?
That's the movie, yeah. By the people who did the original Resident Evil movies.
Right, yeah. At least Resident Evil has the bare bones of a horror movie in it. I don't know who the hell is going to want to see the Monster Hunter.
That's weird. You see, actually, you can play, like, Monster Hunter the game.
Yeah. You can play as Mia Jovovich in it.
Released an update where you can play as Mila Jovovich.
So now you can look as an angry lady all the time.
From, like, the future, though.
Yeah.
Or from another world.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Because she's, like, from our world.
Oh. Wait, does she play herself in the movie? That would be crazy.
Well, she's, like, a soldier or something. Oh. Oh, shit.
I'd be way more into this idea of a movie where Mia Jovovich gets transported to the world of Monster Hunter.
Ah.
And she just has to figure it out.
Green Rabbit didn't enjoy The Witcher like I wanted to. Yeah, I didn't really either, to be honest. I tried with The Witcher, and I just couldn't follow it. I genuinely couldn't follow it from, like, one episode to the other.
None of the characters were likable in it other than The Witcher. And even he's not very likable.
Yeah. Yeah, totally. I remember we talked about this, how we wanted,
like Game of Thrones.
We wanted a Monster of the Week show.
Oh, totally.
With The Witcher just going around slaying monsters.
Yeah.
And having different adventures.
Yeah. Yeah, that would be great.
That's what I want.
That is what the books were at first, too.
Because I felt like Henry Cavill was great.
Oh, well, they're going to keep making that show for a while, I'm sure.
Yeah,
so.
That was like a huge hit for them.
Didn't they make the first season for very cheap? So now that they've got some budget behind it, it might be something interesting.
Green Rabbit says Netflix is releasing a Gremlins prequel cartoon series featuring
a
young Sam Wing trying to find Gizmo's hidden home in Japan. Wow.
I'm into that. Although it's
a story.
I hope it's not for, like, young children.
I know.
I hope they're making it for the people who are, like, our age.
I know Chris Columbus has talked about trying to bring back Gremlins as well, but I do kind of worry without, what's his name, that director?
Sam Raimi? No, not Sam Raimi.
Joe Dante, that's it.
Yeah, Joe Dante, yeah.
Without him being involved.
Yeah, there's not a lot of...
Like, I felt like he was, like, the weirdest.
...made anymore, and there's not really directors that do that anymore.
Yeah.
I don't know, I'd like a Guillermo del Toro Gremlins.
Totally. Yeah, he could keep it weird. That's the thing.
Really,
that's what I mean. You need, like, some weird element like Dante brought.
Yeah.
But, yeah, hopefully it's good. Green Rabbit loves Gremlins. Can't wait. Yeah. Here's hoping. Because if that's successful, maybe they'll...
Yeah.
Bring more of it back.
Totally.
Green Rabbit says, if they made another Gremlins movie, they'd have to stay away from CGI. Yeah, exactly. That's the kind of stuff I would worry about.
Yeah. And then the thing is, then Netflix has to set it in the 80s, because that's when the first ones took place, and then they're just going to make it a new Stranger Things feeling show. Like, it's just going to be such a huge play for nostalgia.
That's not, I don't know, that's not necessarily
bad. No, not at all, but I don't know. Who knows? I think
CGI enhanced puppets like the Dark Crystal show. Yeah, that'd be perfect. Or like Mandalorian Baby Yoda style.
Right, yeah.
Oh, wow. So this cave led to this. This seems more like a castle.
Huh. This is Castlevania.
This is Castlevania Land.
I would go to that theme park.
Totally.
Yeah.
Oh, man. That would also be just a great game, Castlevania game, too. Like, yeah. Like, that would be an awesome modern-day Castlevania. Like, he opens up a theme park.
Oh,
as his new castle. Do I like to get away with making a castle?
Yeah. So then Dracula's this crazed carny? Like
no, he's like Walt Disney.
Oh yeah.
He's like this rich entrepreneur who makes a theme park so that he can suck people's blood, harvest people.
Yeah, that sounds pretty bananas.
Yeah.
It'd be an unlimited amount of people coming to give him their blood.
Exactly. So yeah, Konami, just let us make the next Castlevania game.
And theme park.
That's the thing. It's already got its theme park tie-in ready to go.
Exactly. And those are big money now.
Yeah. Castlevania, the theme park, the game, the theme park.
Oh man. So is it a game called Castlevania the Theme Park the Game?
Yeah.
I'm in. Sounds great.
Oh man. It's getting intense. I fall so far down.
Yeah, it's the game doesn't stay easy at all.
There you go. I need to go this way. Green Rabbit loves how Andy Samberg and Bill Hader voice the Skeksis and the Mystic in Dark Crystal. Oh, that's awesome.
I have not watched the Dark Crystal.
Neither have I, actually. Shit, this is brutal.
Man.
There's just stuff falling from the ceiling. If it knocks me into the water, I'd just die.
Yeah, that's super unfair.
Oh, but there's kind of a trail that shows... Oh, God! Wow. Oh, what a bastard. Damn it, that was bad. It's always confused me. I mean, I'm used to it now, but how Castlevania, like, hearts don't heal you.
Oh, yeah. They always should have made it something different.
Yeah. It's always been.
What did they do with Bloodstains? I can't. Oh, it was like little flowers that came out of them. Like, that's slightly better.
Yeah. Oh no, damn it.
Son of a gun.
Yeah, I definitely, I've been meaning to watch the show forever. I don't watch a lot of TV, to be honest. But there's a decent amount of shows that are on like my list of gotta get around to watching that.
Eventually you'll reach them.
Exactly. But Dark Crystal's definitely on there, and it's only one season, and like it's canceled. So.
Oh, it's over.
Yeah. That's too bad. It is too bad, but at least I often with TV shows I don't like waiting for the next season.
Oh yeah.
To start, so I usually wait till they're all finished. So at least it's all finished, so I know I can watch it, and I don't have to wait for another season. Green Rabbit says it was canceled. Yeah, I believe it was. Pretty sure I read that at some point, and there was some outcry over it.
Yeah,
they've definitely like kept other things on the air for longer that were way crappy.
I feel like everything just gets canceled on Netflix
at this point. Yeah, a lot of stuff too. There was a time where like nothing did.
Right.
It was like,
and then, yeah, sometimes I scroll through Netflix and you know that show The 100. It's up to like 7 seasons.
Yeah, but that I don't think Netflix, I don't think that's a complete Netflix original.
Okay.
Well, pretty sure that's still, just like there. Teens. That's a really popular show.
Is it really popular?
Oh yeah, that's huge. But it's over now. I think that just ended too. Like, well, IGN used to do, like, recaps of that and stuff. And,
it
like,
kind of lost its premise when there wound up being more than 100 people.
Oh, my God. That's such bullshit.
Oh, no.
I was at, like, full health. And he just, like, knocks me off. Man.
Always been the thing with Castlevania. And it almost got worse once they added branching paths. Because then you fall off the level and feel like you're missing stuff.
Oh, yeah. I hated that in... the one on PSP that I played.
I don't know if that's worse than dying.
Oh, what? Why? That's terrifying every time. Jeez. This game. Oh, Tiny Zero really like Santa Clarita Diet. I was sad when that got canceled.
Oh.
Yeah, that got canceled too. That was a good show.
The first season was amazing. The second season was pretty good.
That's the only one I watched. That's the other problem. I watched the first season and then I was like, I'm going to wait till it all comes out. And then
I really liked Kimmy Schmidt. That was canceled. Really good.
Yeah, that one, and that one definitely went through its whole paces. They even did a movie, that one.
Was it a movie or wasn't it the weird game thing?
Yeah, but that was an interactive movie.
Right. It was the worst episode of the whole show.
I never saw it. That's another show that I think I started watching when it was like still coming out. And then decided to wait until it all came out and just haven't got around back to it yet.
Right. That show's got an amazing theme song. Any show with that good is worth its weight in gold.
Oh, I enjoyed it. Yeah, it's a good show.
Yeah. I think the new season of Wellington Paranormal starts right away. That's exciting.
That's cool. What's that, 3 now?
That's season 3. You can't believe it, yeah.
This game.
And didn't What We Do in Shadows get signed on for like 4 more seasons or something ludicrous like that?
Oh, I don't know.
Making a whole bunch more of it.
That's great. More shows I need to watch.
Yeah. Oh man, yeah, the second season of that show was better than the first. It's really good shit.
think that's the same place I died like twice in a row.
Beautiful.
I think this is my last life. So we'll see what happens.
Yeah, I don't know what the continue situation is like.
I guess I could do a save state just to be safe. But I don't
know. New Christmas movie with Keenan Michael Keyes Netflix is also getting really well reviewed.
What's that?
Jingle Jangle or something it's called?
Oh, with Samuel L. Jackson too, I think.
Oh, I didn't know Samuel L. Jackson's in it.
I didn't know Keenan Michael Keyes was in it. Maybe I'm wrong about Samuel Jackson, actually. I didn't know anyone was in it.
Yeah, let me see. Oh, Forrest Whitaker is the main star.
There's
Keaton,
who it is, not Samuel Jackson.
Right.
Yeah,
it's supposed to be really, really, really good.
Also, the like Alien Xmas is another one.
Interesting.
Yeah. I can't remember. He was connected to some kind of classic franchise too, the Alien Xmas guy. Whoops.
Right.
Shit, what am I supposed to be doing here? Fighting this guy. Oh, you bastard. This is not gonna... Oh, what a bastard. Oh, wow, he's hard to hit.
He's a true bastard.
And the wiggle does nothing. No. Oh, wow. I can go down here. That's cool. Oh, I got one of his heads. Wow. That was so close. I had one hit left.
Holy
and I hit his crap. Fire and his head at the same time. Whew.
Brilliant. I think there are only like 8 levels and you're 4 levels in.
Wow.
Yeah, you're churning through it.
Oh, I remember fighting a werewolf. It's just in my brain. Oh, have we seen Krampus? I think Grimpen has.
Oh yeah, I like Krampus. Krampus is good.
Yeah, it's always looked
the Adam Scott classic. Yeah.
didn't like Alien Xmas. Rather watch Grimpen Christmas Shopping. Oh, that's too bad. I heard good things about it, but you never know. Let's see though. One second.
Seeing what else he's associated with?
Yeah.
Let's see. As far as, not on IMDb, there isn't anything. I don't know. Alien Xmas looks like it's very young kid stuff. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know much about it, really.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I don't know what it was. Not worth the effort.
Nope. Very rarely is.
Trying to do this Alien Xmas? Yeah, it's just another Netflix, a new Netflix, like, Christmas movie.
Yeah.
But, yeah. I probably wouldn't have watched it anyway.
I watched a new movie on Shudder the other day that's just called Porno. About like some teens in like a really religious town release a succubus by watching a movie in their movie.
That's a good premise.
It was fine. It was entertaining enough.
Porno, that's not a good title though.
It's a terrible title.
You need something better than that. Especially if your main character is a succubus. There's got to be something better you can come up with.
I don't think that movie exists yet.
That probably does.
Maybe.
Call it Succubus. Make her a bus driver.
Or call it Sex Ghoul.
Perfect. There you go.
Yeah. Everyone wants to see that.
Wow, I did terrible after I died there. I think I went back pretty far, but we're almost done here. We're not just talking about succubus smoothies. Aliens.
It's what happens when my sleepiness overtakes my interest.
Totally.
I have to think of anything else to occupy my mind.
That's, yeah. I start playing terribly.
Perfect.
Oh shit, I thought that was like a platform under that window.
Oh no!
It's weird, the Wikipedia article specifically mentions, like one of the ways they wanted to make it less frustrating for players was to make it easier for Simon to walk up stairs. And it's like, not easy.
But I think you can jump onto stairs in this game. And you could never do that previously. But yeah, it still sucks.
I don't know how you can. Oh, yeah, there you can. Know. Yeah. Maybe that's what they were talking about.
So much less frustrating.
I'm like, somehow, like, I'm in a mode somehow where I'm, like, walking straight up it. So maybe there's a way for me to, like, go. I don't know. Like, I don't know how to not walk up these stairs.
Oh, man. What an insane problem. We need to be playing that inventions game. I don't know how to not walk up these stairs. I don't know what you could do about that.
I guess just maybe some kind of portable stairs.
Or portable stairs.
You're always walking upstairs.
Oh, yeah. I'd find some way to break the stairs. End the cycle.
Wow, look at those guys. They're pretty awesome. Like monkey skeletons.
Yeah, that's a chilling type of skeleton.
Ah, I totally jumped. Yeah, Castlevania, Dracula has a pretty awesome collection of skeletons.
Totally, he should employ them at his theme park.
Exactly. He's already got all the makings of a theme park right there. Yeah. Monkey skeletons? Oh, shit.
Swinging hooks and all kinds of things like that.
Totally. What am I supposed to do there? I swear I've done it before, but it's like, feels like now it's taking too long for me to. Like, I'm. Like, as soon as I land, it takes me a second to jump again.
Huh.
Oh, maybe. I think I have to not jump. From high up, so I have to like.
Oh, I don't, you have to like to it?
I don't know.
Can you just run off it and land on it that way?
I do. I think it's gonna fall before that. It'll let me do that though. Oh, I could not walk upstairs by jumping through the stairs. Oh, wait. If I just walk over it. I don't know.
I don't know.
Last time I somehow did it without even thinking about it. Oh, if you don't jump on them, they don't. Turn?
Ah!
Yeah, those are weird guys. Oh, God. Go down the stairs, Balon.
I can't not be walking on these stairs.
That's what I want from the Castlevania show. It's just a segment where Simon Belmont struggles with stairs.
Oh, that would be amazing.
No, not you're walking around the stairs now, Simon. No, that's
you might have like it. Serious phobia. That could be it. And you're just
now you've somehow jumped up and through the stairs. I don't know. How did I do it before? I must have been some kind of genius earlier.
Yeah, probably.
I'm like, can you jump on the first set or at the set on the edge here so it throws you forward through the other? And walking off of the first green one, you don't get...
Oh my god. You just instantly knocked me straight down.
But you want to be on those stairs. You should just make a save point right before this edge here.
Yeah, but I don't want to... Like, this is such an inconvenient way to load.
Oh, that's
saves
true.
That I can't, like... I have to go to this thing every time I want to load one.
That's too bad. I don't know. And walking forward doesn't do it? Do you have a slide of any kind?
Oh, there we go. I don't know why that worked that time.
Just gotta pogo your way across.
I tried just jumping straight up instead of jumping over. Oh. Maybe that let me jump, get up slightly faster. I don't know. Don't know what I did. But I did it. I'm still a genius.
You did the thing.
I think you just have to, like, yeah, I don't know. Be light on your feet.
Important.
Oh no! Got a lot harder on level 4.
That's not ideal.
Wonder how far I got on the Wii. Controller power.
Oh no.
Somehow. Oh well. That's good enough.
It's a sign from the heavens.
It's a sign from the heavens. The day is done.
Yeah.
Oof. Another gaming history in the bag.
That bag is just full of games.
Full of games at this point. So many games. And there'll be more games next week.
Uh-huh.
We're going to be putting up a whole new gaming board that you can choose from. I can't even talk today. Yeah, there'll be 5 new games to choose from tomorrow. We're getting pretty close. I'm pretty sure there's this week, and then the next week is like where we combine them.
What do you mean combine them?
So it'll include our like Christmas break week.
Oh, right. Crazy.
Yeah.
Right, it's December.
It's getting close. But anyway, yeah, it's getting exciting. And getting hard, actually, to choose games. There's a lot of... December's a lot thinner of a month for video games than November is.
Yeah, it's true. But there are some big ones, but usually only like one a week.
Yeah, yeah, there's still some... And there's some weird stuff still, so... Stay tuned. You can always go to @InScrimpin to vote for the next games that we'll play next week. And before that, though, we're going to play some Jackbox Party Pack on Friday. And something different on Monday. We'll announce that over the weekend. Yeah.
Yeah. Resident Evil 6 DLC.
No, Resident Evil's done. No more Resident Evil 6. Yeah.
Man.
Thank God. Thanks for watching. Lacko, Tiny Observer, Green Rabbit, Alex KC, McKinley, and Kovacs12. Watch it on the replay right now.
Oh, wow. You think he's already started and he's just watching a slightly older... Oh, no, you can't watch the... I don't know how the replays work on Twitch, actually.
Hmm.
Yeah. Wow.
That's it.
Too tech about it. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, Lacko's going to go to bed.
I should also.
He's probably just going to do that and go to bed.
Yeah. It's a smart move.
Even though it's the afternoon here.
Yeah. Hey, there's nothing wrong. It's always evening somewhere.
That's right. It's the evening in Germany right now. I was going to bed. Yeah.
Some people use that phrase to excuse alcoholism. I use it to excuse sleeping all the time.
Ah.
Yeah.
That's why you're an innovator.
I'm an innovator. That's what they call me. Grimp innovator.
It's 11 there, says Laco. Oh, yeah.
Gosh, it's 3 here.
It's 3 p.m. here, yeah. Or that's what? 13? No.
15
o'clock.
Yeah, that's the time.
Well, that's it. And we're almost done with Antsy Pants theme here.
Theme.
We'll be back to Grimpy Gaming soon enough.
Wow. What?
Wow, we are out of it today. So we should probably just go like Lunar Game, 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 Lunar Game.